Hey everyone, Nick here, and I just saw this comment here on one of my videos in our Power Building Reports in PowerPoint playlist. And the comment here is from MMA Lifestyle Apparel. It says, at Spotlight Impact Data Design, hey, another resizing question. Do you have something that explains how to insert an image into an image text box, but it retains the image box sizing and not the original ratio of the image? Well, thank you, MMA Lifestyle Apparel. I'm going to heart that comment, and I'm going to show you how to do that here in PowerPoint. Now, PowerPoint has several different placeholders, and they have two of them are the ones that I want to talk to you about today. So one of them is the content placeholder. That's this one right here. You know it's content placeholder because it has all of these types of inputs right here, from charts, photos, tables, media, etc. And then there's just a picture placeholder, and that just has a little icon for a photo. Now, you could click this icon and upload a picture from your device or from online somewhere like that. But this is the one that you want, because a picture will fill the picture placeholder with the entire height and width of the placeholder. But if you put a picture into a content placeholder like this, it will give you the exact same, it will fill that placeholder, but with the exact same dimensions of the photos. So you can see right here, this photo is a nice tall rectangular photo. It's much different than these square options. If I paste this photo into the content placeholder, it should look exactly like this, only a little bit smaller. It'll fill the height of the placeholder, but it will really just be the exact same dimensions. It'll be a nice high rectangle. If I paste this photo into the picture placeholder, it should fill the entire area of this square with this photo. So let's go ahead and give it a try. The first thing I'm going to do is right click and copy this photo. So that's on my clipboard. Now I'm going to paste it into this box. So just highlight the area of the content box, right click and put paste. Go to paste. And you can see when I paste it, it gives me the exact same photo in the exact same dimensions within sort of that area of the content placeholder. But if I put it into the picture placeholder, it should fill the entire area of this square. So let's try the same thing. Right click, copy, and I'm going to activate the box. I'm going to right click and I'm going to say paste. And there you go. You see the photo fills the entire area of that placeholder and crops the photo just a little bit too. Now, this photo is perfect. It's right on this woman's face. It's exactly where I wanted it to be. But if for some reason it went to another part of the photo, maybe it cut off half the face or something like that, you can crop the image within the placeholder. So just click the photo to highlight it, go up to the Picture Format tab, and then click on Crop. Now you can see, I see the entire dimension of the photo is here in gray, but just the crop area is right here. So I could click and drag this photo down if I wanted to do that. And then when I've put it in the exact right position, I'll click crop again. And now the photo is cropped to what I want to do. Now, if you go up to if you're in the Home tab and you go up to the New Slide Layouts, this is where you'll see all of PowerPoint's default layouts. They have title and text placeholders here, along with content and photo placeholders. But you can see that among the default layouts, there's only one with a picture placeholder. And so if you want to create your own picture placeholder with a different size, you can do that by going to, you click out of that, you're going to go to the View tab. When you go to the View tab, you're going to click on Slide Master. When you click on Slide Master, that reveals all of the different default layouts and the different master layouts that you have access to, and you can actually create new ones. So I'm going to go here. I'm just going to click in the middle here, and I'm going to right-click and say Insert Layout so I can make a new layout. It's much better to insert new layouts when you're creating custom layouts than it is to edit the existing layouts, because that can give you some problems later on down the line if you're creating PowerPoint templates or you're merging slides or things like that. So just create a new layout, and here's my new layout. All the layouts come with default with a title and with these footer boxes here, but you won't see those unless you activate them in the normal view, so don't worry about that. Now I want my custom picture placeholder. So go up here to the Master Layout menu and click on this drop-down that says Insert Placeholder. When you click on that, you'll get all of these different options for placeholders: content, text, picture, chart, etc. We want the picture placeholder. So when I click on this, it's going to give this little box for my cursor, and now I'm ready. I can just click and drag to see how long I want, to see what I want this placeholder to look like. I'm going to make this a big rectangle picture placeholder here. Now this looks like a nice rectangle here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go back to the normal view. So what you need to do is click on the View tab again. And instead of the Slide Master, go over here to Presentation Views and click on Normal. Now we're back to our presentation that we started with. I'm going to insert a new slide from the new slide menu, and you'll see that we have the custom layout here right in the beginning. That's the one that we just created. And it's by default, it's named one underscore custom layout. I'm going to go ahead and click it. It'll insert that custom layout. And now I'm going to paste in this picture from the other slide. So let's go over here. I'm going to go back to my photo here on the pasteboard. I'm going to right click to copy. And then I'm going to go to my new layout, and I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to activate my custom picture placeholder. I'm going to right click to paste, and the photo will fill the entire width and height, the entire area of that custom picture placeholder. So I hope this helps out, MMA Apparel Lifestyle, Lifestyle Apparel. And if you like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. I hope you subscribe to my channel. You'll get updates on new tutorials in data design, Excel, and PowerPoint. I hope you found this video useful, and thanks again for watching. I'll see you next time.